Chris. A-hole Productions.
We know each other so well, don't we, Lance?
Well, we've always been each other's greatest nemesis. This is Psy. Nemesis. What's the plural on that?
Nemesis.
Whatever.
Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Nemeseek, and we are continuing our coverage for Resident Evil Village from TGS 2020 that is going on this weekend. It's Saturday right now. We got the one presentation yesterday, and I pulled some bits of information that I thought were interesting to talk about and bring to you guys. So that's what these are. I deleted that live stream, and now we're just doing these. And I think there's another presentation tomorrow on Sunday. I hope that shows more gameplay, because then I can make a full video on the gameplay, and we can talk a little bit about that and the setting of the game and more about that stuff. But for now, we're just going to make these like three quick videos. We talked about Ethan in the first one. This one's going to be a little bit about more about the story outside and around Ethan. It's this new element they're bringing to the game. A lot of people had questions about it. Some people think it doesn't fit. And so I want to get your perspective on that, which is this fairy tale book thing that they showed in the demonstration, like the behind the scenes look. Because we saw that in the new trailer where it's like this, you know, Coraline type. You know, when I did my video reaction, I was like, oh, that kind of reminds me of Coraline or like a Tim Burton feel. And so people were like, what is that? Why are they putting that in there? That's not very Resident Evil. I actually feel like if it's what I think it is, because I'm going to give you my theory. Because when I saw that trailer, the first thing I thought of, one of the first things I thought of was what I'm about to say, my theory on this. So if it's that, then it's very Resident Evil, just done in a different way. In the interview, they talk about these fairy tales. So there's this book, I think, called the Something of Shadows or something like that. And this book is explaining this story that we heard Mia read in the first trailer. If you notice, no one ever sees Mia's face in any of the trailers. And a lot of the times they show her, she has like this yellow lighting with her, which usually typically in storytelling, you would use that lighting for flashbacks. So makes me wonder how much of this story is in Ethan's memories and how much of it is, you know, happening now. Like obviously the gameplay and everything you're doing in Village is now, but it seems like a lot of the Mia stuff might be flashbacks, which makes sense because I would imagine if they start the story, they want to start you right away. Like Chris comes in, takes you, that's the opening cutscene. And then you wake up in this village and you're like, what's going on? And then you spend the whole game looking for answers. And why Ethan is chosen by Chris to be brought here or whatever the case is. And I'm thinking it has something to do with Mia, because I think a lot of us forget, because I said, like, you know, Ethan's not much of a character in Resident Evil 7, but Mia was, because we find out that Mia worked for the Connections or whatever that group was. And there's also the other group called Tenso or whatever, Tensuo. And so they have them as well that are out there that, like, helped make Evelyn. So, and I think the Connections might be their rival. And then you also have Wesker's group, HCF and stuff. So there's a lot of factions going on here. And maybe Chris is actually trying to get to the bottom of it, and maybe he found out a lot more about Mia than even Ethan knows, you know? So I don't know. I'm curious to see where this goes and what they do with it. But the fairy tale thing is really interesting, because my thought was, what if the fairy tales, like in Resident Evil 7, you have to find VHS tapes, right? Or notes, you know? And like in most Resident Evil games, you find little notes that tell you the backstory on stuff. Well, what if in this one, they decided to do more visualization of notes or the VHS tapes? Because in the VHS tapes in Resident Evil 7, you played through them to learn about how to solve puzzles or get through certain areas. What if in this one, they're like, hey, this map is really big. It's expansive. We're not going to really give you hints like that. You're going to have to figure it out on your own. But instead, now if you find these books instead of VHS tapes, you'll now watch cutscenes of this story that you might think is not connected to Ethan's story. But I have a feeling it's gonna have a lot more parallels to what's going on with Ethan than I think most people think. So, because they show, like, you know, what's Mia says, like, what? It's just a fairy tale. And it's like, okay. The way she says that is almost like she's in on it. Like, she knows that it's not just a fairy tale. And so I think that's going to be really great to explore that and that relationship between Ethan and Mia, and maybe see parallels of their lives through this series of fairy tales. And so I think that's a great idea, actually, because you're also in a village, and the village has these, like, these, I'm assuming, you know, they have these beliefs, you know, and they have these folklores and these tales of their village that you know, explain why there's a castle at the end, because obviously, like remember Edward Scissorhands? I know this is probably a bad example, but like everyone lives in these nice, quaint, you know, 70s style houses, and then at the end of the block was like a haunted mansion and stuff, like a big castle where Edward Scissorhands lived, and everyone in the neighborhood had stories of what was in that house. You know, when I was a kid, I grew up on a street, and there was a really dilapidated house in the end, and people made up stories about, you know, a witch that lived there, an old lady that lived there. So I think that's kind of neat that there's these folklore tales in this place, and you're going to read them, hopefully, maybe through these books that you find throughout the game. But the other thing to note of these, so that's my theory. I think that they're replacing VHS tapes, and they'll help tell you the backstory of this village, because I imagine you're in a whole new country, a whole new territory. You're going to want to learn about it so that you care, because the one thing they kept saying was, oh, this village is very much going to feel like a character, which is a cliche thing to say. A lot of people do that. They're like, oh, we really made New York a character in this movie, or we really made San Francisco a character. And it's really never true. They just say it because they've heard other people say it, and they just think, yeah, we put a lot of focus on the city. And it's like, eh, but you really didn't. So it's hard to really believe them, but if this fairy tale stuff, you know, expands on lore of that place, then yeah, I guess they do kind of make it a character. Because in the Resident Evil 2 remake, they did a pretty good job expanding the lore of Raccoon City a little bit. I think in Resident Evil 3, they contracted the lore a bit, because I felt like there was a lot more about, you know, the guy who designed the trains and things like that, like in the old files from Resident Evil 3, and a lot of that wasn't in the new ones, you know, even though they had a place where you could deal with the subway trains, but they weren't above ground trolleys, so you lost that history. You didn't go to St. Michael Clock Tower. So I felt like Resident Evil 3 contracted the lore of Resident Evil, of Raccoon City. And this sounds like it's going to try to expand on this lore of this new place you're going to, which makes a lot of sense. So that's my theory. I think it's going to replace VHS tapes. So let me know if you agree or disagree with that. But then the last thing I want to talk about that's dealing with these lores is something one of the directors said, which is he said, what he finds frustrating in video games sometimes is when there's a lot of story elements and there's nothing to really tie them together. And he said, so we wanted to create these fairy tale books that you find in the game. Or I don't know if he didn't really say fairy tale books in the game. I'm you know, adding that. But he said this fairy tale, the story, however it's delivered to us in the game, he said, this is going to tie a lot together. So again, I think it's going to parallel Ethan's story or his adventure or his journey through this game. I think you're by the time you get to the end of the fairy tale book, I think you're probably going to see Ethan in a completely new way or his story in a completely new way, because you're going to realize how factual it probably was to his life or to his what he's going through. And then also the elements of like werewolves being here and, you know, potential witches who suck blood, because there's like that scene where the woman like sucks Ethan's like blood out of his hand or something, and then later you see his hand bandaged, I think it was. I saw a piece of that on Barry's live or one of his videos, I think. But that was good observation on Barry's part and other people's part who helped him, you know, if anyone contributed to that video, because that was, I didn't realize that. I saw that his hand was getting blood sucked out, but I didn't notice the bandages. So that's pretty neat that that could be a thing. And that's also awful because that's the hand Ethan got cut off and got stitched back on. So I'm kind of curious if maybe that's why she chose that hand to suck the blood out of, because maybe there's still remnants of, you know, the Evelyn virus or something inside of him, or maybe the healingness of the herb or something that's, you know, that they poured on his wrist. So I'm curious, we'll see. But to hear that there is a lot of weird elements in this game that aren't traditionally Resident Evil, like werewolves, potentially witches, potentially vampires, or whatever else the rumors are they're hinting at, the fact that this fairy tale is going to tie all that together makes a lot of sense, because I feel like you're going to find out this fairy tale, it starts off and it's very fairy tale-ish. A mom, a daughter, you know, the kid runs away or whatever the story is. And then I bet you they're going to reveal that these creatures are not mystical, like that they're not supernatural, and that they may be science-based, and that maybe this village and this castle has a connection to past Resident Evil stories in some way. At least that's what I'm hoping for. Again, all theory stuff. So let me know what you think. If you agree with me, disagree with me, what do you think these fairy tale books are? Like, do you think it'll be books throughout the game, like VHS tapes, that you can just, every time you find one, it tells you more of the story and it ties everything together better? Or do you think it'll just be cutscenes that, you know, randomly just pop up in the game? You don't do anything to activate them, just to help tell the story more. Like, you know, I'd love to hear your thoughts. What do you think it is? And are you happy to see something like this and see something new? Because, you know, it is a completely new world. It's a new environment. The village looks unlike most Resident Evil games, although when I take one look at it, it's clear that they probably pick this setting so they can reuse a ton of assets for a Resident Evil 4 remake, because that's what it feels like also. But I'm fine with that, because even the menu screen when you have your inventory looks a lot like Resident Evil 4. So I'm like, okay, that's fine. I don't mind them reusing assets. It's a smart business move. So that's cool, as long as they tell a good story in both games, and I'm hoping they do with this one. And this one I'm very excited for, because I liked 7 a lot, and I'm very excited to see something that is more horror based, which they said this one will be, but also more character based, which I'm very excited for. So let me know what you think of the lore and all the fairy tale stuff down in the comments below, and we'll continue our conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in Raccoon City. Peace.